And now, the analysis procedure.
Open Mach1 analysis and open the folder path containing the result files. Now let's analyze the setup compliance. Click on Find Contact and choose the force in the Z direction as a vertical axis and position Z as the horizontal axis. Now from the analysis drop-down menu list, select Slope. Now drag the cursors to in the region of interest, as you can see here, which is the region within the sample's load range. And report the measured slope as the setup compliance slope. Then we will analyze the bending test of the wood. So click on the file and select Move Relative. Click on the slope analysis and drag the cursors in the region of interest, which corresponds to the linear region of the curve for the analysis, and report the slope as the measured slope. Now we will calculate the corrected slope considering the setup compliance slope obtained previously. We will then analyze the load displacement curve to obtain the maximum force. So in the analysis drop-down menu list, we will select min and max and drag the cursors in the region of interest where the maximum force is needed. The red dot appears and the maximum force corresponds to the max y in the results field. There you go. Now we will do the same analysis for the bending test of the bone of the rat femur. So select Move Relative, and now using the slope analysis, select the linear region of the curve. You can zoom in order to help to have a better view of the load displacement curve. So now let's select the linear region of the curve and report the value, the slope, as the measured slope. And once again, we will obtain the corrected slope considering the setup compliance. Now let's obtain the maximum force. Drag the cursors in a region of interest where the maximum force is needed and the red dot appears. And you have your maximum force as the max y value, as you can see it here.
The slope obtained from the analysis corresponds to the measured bending stiffness of the sample. The entire system can be modeled as two springs connected in series, where the top spring consists of the setup compliance and the bottom spring consists of the actual deformation in the sample. Therefore, the measured slope needs to be corrected to obtain accurate intrinsic mechanical properties resulting from the bending test. The sample's shape and dimensions also need to be considered. For a circular section, the area moment of inertia and section modulus are calculated as shown, while for a tube section, they are calculated as shown. Use the following equation involving the slope, the span length, and the area moment of inertia to obtain the elastic modulus in bending. And the following equation to calculate the maximum flexural strength. Now, let's consider the data from the three-point bending test of the birch wood sample. The span length being 24 millimeters, and the diameter being 3.1 millimeters. Here is the measured load displacement curve of the birch wood sample. And now, the data from the three-point bending test of the rat femur sample. The span length being 14 millimeters, the diameter being 3.7 millimeters, and the cortical wall thickness being 0.75 millimeter. Here is the measured load displacement curve of the rat femur sample. The elastic modulus in bending and the maximum flexural strength can be obtained.